All the way to the Senate session hall, people unknown to the late Senator Edgardo Angara and those who have worked with him lined up to pay their last respect. Angara spent more than 20 years of life as a senator. These aside from extending his time, knowledge, and dedication in the executive department as a law professor, a university president, and a lawyer. As a legislator, Angara also experienced how to be a Senate president and a minority leader. Minority Leader Franklin Drilon is a fraternity brother and a law firm partner of Angara. He was Angara's friend for almost 50 years. Drilon credited Angara for his landmark laws, which today benefit the youth, farmers, the underprivileged, and the elderly. These include the law creating the Commission on Higher Education, or CHED, Agriculture and Fisheries Modernization Act, TESDA Law, and the Senior Citizens Law. Angara's other sterling record, according to Drilon, being a good husband.
To Gloria, Anna, Sunny, Katya, and Alex, you lost a great husband and an amazing father. I lost a dear friend.
Lawmaker Pia Cayetano's voice cracked several times as she remembered how Angara, whom she looks up as her second father, assisted her when she was still a UP student and a volleyball player. When they won the UAAP, Angara, then the UP president, rewarded them with a one-year scholarship program.
Filipino grieve because we have lost a humble and dedicated statesman.
It was Angara who also guided and encouraged the likes of Senators Joel Villanueva and Juan Miguel Zubiri to always aim for the best. But according to Zubiri, amid his sterling performance as a public servant, Angara would always tell him his biggest regret in life.
One of his biggest regrets is that he didn't spend as much time with his family. You, Sunny, he loved you very much.
Angara's contemporaries, former Senators Aquilino Pimentel Jr. and Rene Sagisag, meantime recalled their adventures during the martial law years. Former Presidents Gloria Arroyo and Joseph Estrada also offered good words and memories about their late colleague.
I had such high hopes for our team when I chose him as my running mate in the 1998 presidential election.
The impact of your principled work is larger than life.
Angara's son and namesake, Senator Sunny Angara, described his father as a man who loved his country and helped build a better nation for future generations of Filipinos. The necrological service was capped by the Senate's recognition of Angara's contributions to the institution and the nation.
Sabi nga niya, being in the Senate is like being on a high promontory in the Philippines with an unobstructed view. He was witness to the passage of history and persons, a privileged participant in charting the future of the nation. What we request is that all of you here remember our father fondly as a reformer, as an institution builder, as a builder of dreams, an enabler of dreams, an enabler of people.
Angara's remains left the Senate halls at 2 in the afternoon. The 83-year-old lawmaker will be laid to rest on Sunday in his hometown in Baler, Aurora. Sherrie Ann Torres, ABS-CBN News.